Hello everybody and welcome to my YouTube channel. My name's Laura and today I will be showing you a really quick, easy recipe for cookies or biscuits. You can use any flavouring or filling you like. You could use fruit, nuts, cinnamon, other spices. Today I'll be using chocolate chips and really hope you like my video. So the first thing I like to do before I start baking is to make a list of everything I'm going to need and usually the method as well, because I keep looking at it on my phone and I'm sure you're the same and you just get your phone covered in stuff. So in order to make these cookies, you really don't need much equipment at all. You need a mixing bowl and a set of scales. You need a mixer. You could use a hand whisk if you don't have an electric mixer. I've also got this spatula, which is really cute, also from Wilko. It's from their Great British Bake Off range. I'm using Everyday Value plain flour from Tesco because I think flour is just flour. I've got caster sugar, also from Tesco, and my milk chocolate chips, which I'll add in nearer the end, and I'll use about half the bag. And that really is all you need. It is that simple. Oh, and butter. I forgot to get it out of the fridge. You can use any butter that you like. You don't have to use this one. This one's not specifically for baking, but you can buy some from Flora, for example, that are made specifically for baking. So the first thing I'm doing is setting the oven to 180 degrees. It's easiest to do this right at the beginning because it's not going to take you long to make this simple recipe. Now I'm just unboxing my new mixer. We've only just moved into this house, so I'm still buying everything that I need, hence having to borrow my nan's scales. They're probably not the most accurate, but hey, it's an easy recipe. The first ingredient you're going to want to add to your mixing bowl is the butter, and you want 225 grams. It looks like a lot, but don't freak out. It makes quite a few biscuits. So the aim here is just to get the butter to be light and fluffy. You're not trying to mix anything into it just yet. It's just to get it light and fluffy, so it shouldn't take you very long. So once you're happy with that, the next thing to add is the caster sugar. You want 110 grams, and I wouldn't bother sieving it or anything because you're just going to mix it in anyway. It's all fine. So you want to mix the caster sugar in until it's completely smooth and almost runny. You then want to add 275 grams of plain flour, and this you should sieve, but as I said, we've just moved into the house, I do not have a sieve, so we'll just see what happens. Okay, so now I realised why you sieve it. I put way too much in, so please excuse me just removing what I should have done if I followed my own instructions. Anyhow, moving on. The next step you want to do is get your mixer again and you want to keep mixing until you've got a breadcrumb-like texture. Then it'll get to the point where the mixture's kind of too thick for you to use the mixer on, so you'll have to get your hands in there. You will have to. I'm sorry. So now I'm going to use my spatula. I knew it would come in handy. So what I'm doing now is just scraping all the loose flour and butter and mixed sugar from the side so that when I put my hands in, it doesn't go all sticky and horrible. So it's at this point that you should add anything else you're going to chuck in there. I'm adding my chocolate chips at this point, then you just want to mix it with either the spatula or just mix them in with your hands so that they're evenly distributed. Once you've mixed it all in, it should look like a big blob of dough. Once you're happy with your mixture, you can start making small little balls of dough about the size of a £2 coin. And put them on your baking tray. After all of that, the oven should be heated up just fine, and you can now put them in the oven. Set a timer for 13 minutes. If you want them to be a bit more cakey, doughy-like in texture, do them for 12 to 13 minutes. If you like a harder, crunchier biscuit, then 15 to 16 minutes. Now, as we all know, the one downside to baking is the clearing up. Look at all this mess. Also, after making all those 12 biscuits, I've also got all of this mixture left. So once those are out the oven in 13 minutes, I'm gonna make another batch, woo! In the meantime though, I will definitely have to clear up this mess. So I made yet another error. Before I put them in the oven, I should have pushed them down with a fork. I'm not entirely sure what this actually does. I guess it just helps them cook more evenly. Another back in the oven, the alarm is on for 13 minutes and now it's time to do some clearing up. Oh, they look good though. Now the kitchen's all clean and tidy again, exactly what I like to see, and all of that and the washing up and everything took me a grand total of 12 minutes, so we have 1 minute left on the clock. So the alarm's gone off, I've turned it off, and look in the oven to find 12 amazing biscuits. The house smells amazing. I just love baking. So as I said, this was after 13 minutes, so if you wanted them a bit browner on the top, you could do them for literally a couple more minutes and they'd be fine. I'm leaving them for a few minutes just to cool on the tray, just because I haven't done them for very long. I prefer my cookies to be a bit more chewy inside, so I don't want them to lose their shape. Now I'm just moving them off the tray onto the cooling rack, and oh, I want to eat them now. These cookies will keep for ages. You can store them in loads of different ways, in a Tupperware box or just in some tin foil. We'll be keeping ours in our little biscuit tin. Also, as I had loads of mixture left, I'm just making another batch. Unfortunately, it doesn't quite make 24 altogether. It made 23, but I think mine were a bit bigger than £2 coins. And here's the finished product, 23, maybe 24, amazing cookies. I've tried them, I really love them. My fiance really loves them. And because they're so quick and easy, they're such a great idea for if you've got family or friends coming round. You could do a few different flavors and it wouldn't be too much effort at all. Thanks everyone. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Leave a like if you liked it and I hope to see you all again soon. Bye.